Alhamdulillah, I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving me the opportunity to meet so many souls. This is a rare opportunity that we all need to take the most advantage of, because we may all never meet again together in one space after this gathering. So Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, I hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has looked at us in this gathering and has given us His Ridwan, His pleasure with us. Because I'm sure all of you came here with one purpose in mind, which is to increase in knowledge, to learn something that will make you a better believer. And to pursue knowledge, to seek knowledge, gives the very meaning to our existence. You all know the famous story of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, that even though he was a prophet and a messenger, and one of the Ulil Azim, what they call the messengers of high resolution, they usually count five of them, Ulil Azim, Ibrahim, Nuh, Musa, Isa, and Muhammad alayhim salatu wassalam. They call them Ulul Azm. They are the messengers who have faced the greatest risk in performing their duty. So with all that, he said he left his people, he left his community, and he's leader of the community in pursuit of further knowledge, because he heard that somebody knew something that he did not know, and that person was Al-Khidr, you know the story of Kahf. So that is a lesson for all of us, that you can never know enough, that as long as there is somebody who knows more than you need to go and seek knowledge. That's what Ibn Mas'ud, the famous Sahabi, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, says, that if I know that behind this ocean there is someone who knows more than me, I'll throw myself in the ocean and go and seek him. So alhamdulillah, you are all motivated by such a thing, such a noble motive. It's a pleasure. And inshallah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us barakah in what we already know and barakah in what we are about to learn. So the topic of the characteristic of a believer, or the character of a believer. Probably we will begin by defining what the word character means in terms of Quran and Sunnah. The Arabic word for character is khuluq, singular, and akhlaq, plural. And there is a term called at-takhalluq, meaning that to acquire something as your character, at-takhalluq. That implies that usually we are not born with these noble characters. We have to acquire them. Even though some people are born with kind of some type of inclination to certain types of characteristics, but you still have to polish it and make it better. But generally, we have to acquire them. That is the story of the famous Sahabi called Al-Ashaj Bani Qais, they call him. He came in a delegation that came to visit the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam in Medina. They call that year the year of delegations, Amul Wufud, about the ninth year of Hijrah, when people are coming in delegations to offer their pledge, to pledge their allegiance to Islam. So a delegation came from Bani Abdul Qais. And among them there was one man, they called him Ashaj, Bani Qais. When the caravan arrived in Medina, everyone in the caravan, they left the caravan quickly and they wanted to meet the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they left the caravan like that. Except him, he stayed behind them. So he took care of the caravan, he rested the camels and gave them food, and then when he was done with that, took care of their luggage, put everything together in a safe place, and then he went and took his shower and then changed his dresses. And then he came late, he came last to see the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam. So when he came and he greeted him and sat down, the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam looked at him and then said to him, Inna fika la khaliqatani yuhibbuhum Allah wa rasuluhu. Hadith in Bukhari. Inna fika la khaliqatani yuhibbuhum Allah wa rasuluhu. He said to him, you have two characteristics that Allah and his messenger love. Inna fika la khaliqatani yuhibbuhum Allah wa rasuluhu. Then he said to the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, أَتَخَلَّقْتُ بِهِمَا أَمْ جُبِلْتُ عَلَيْهِمَا. He said, have I acquired these characteristics or was it inherent in me, something that I was born with, I'm naturally inclined to? The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam said to him, بَلْ جُبِلْتَ عَلَيْهِمَا. He said, indeed, you are naturally inclined. Then he said to him, those two characteristics that you have, that Allah loves and his messenger loves as well, al-hilmu wal-anat. Al-hilmu wal-anat. Hilm comes from Allah's name, al-halim. We're going to come to that. Hilm means to be magnanimous in the etymological sense of the word. Magnus animus, meaning that you have a very broad chest. You are not somebody who can be provoked easily. You are forbearing. You are clement. So all these are within the meaning of Al-Hilm, or Allah's name Al-Halim. You don't get angry. You don't get angry. So Al-Halim, that's one thing. He said, you have Hilm. And then the second one, he said, Al-Anat. You are somebody who does not rush. I mean, you take your time. Because he noticed that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so he's going to be a good judge of character. This is the one of the highest type of knowledge, to see people and know their character. Because only by knowing people's character, you can direct them in the proper direction. You know their potential. And you can help them how to bring that potential out. So you have to be able to judge their character very accurately. So he judged his character accurately. When he came late, he took his time. So he said that you are Halim, because when they all rushed and leave him with all the work to do, they all left him with the camels and everything, and they came to get the opportunity to see the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But he did not get angry. Why did they leave me alone with all this work? Why should I clean up after them? That's what somebody who gets angry will say. I don't care, so I'll go also, I'll leave everything here. He did not get angry. He stayed behind, he took care of everything. So that's one. And he did not rush to come. He took his time. He showered, he bathed, and then changed his clothes, and then he came last. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا أَتَيْتُمُ السَّلَاةَ, if you come to prayer, فَأَتُوهَا وَأَنْتُمْ عَلَيْكُمُ السَّكِينَ وَالْوَقَارَ, when you come to prayer, come to prayer, you are in a calm state. You are in a imperturbed state. Don't come to prayer as some people do. They come running and they join the line. You can hear them breathing loudly. You say, don't do that. That's not a way to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're out of breath. Come with sakina and waqar. Just walk gently. عباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض حونا. The servant of Ar-Rahman who walk on the earth gently. عباد الرحمن. So وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما. So they are two things. They walk gently, that means they don't rush. So they walk at a good pace, not too fast and not too slow. So, waqsid fi mashika, the advice of Luqman to his son, waqsid fi mashika, waqdud min sawtika. Be middling in your walk, Luqman is saying to his son. Don't walk too fast, but not too slow either. You become sluggish. So neither hasty nor sluggish. So walk a walk that is in between them. So وَإِذَا خَاتَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا, and when those, the ignorant, accosted them, once you pick up trouble with them, they don't get angry. They said peace. So those are عِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ, those who don't rush, not in a haste, and those who then get provoked and made angry. So that's called Hilmu and Anad. So two characteristics. But these two characters are components of one big character. Anybody can guess what character is that?
Sabr.
Exactly. Sabr. So if you break sabr down, it comes down to this two. If you break it down. So when we say somebody is sabr, somebody is patient, that's what we mean. That he has hilm al-anat. You break it down. Because when you say somebody is patient, it's very abstract, it's very vague. What do you mean actually by somebody being patient? You mean that somebody who doesn't get angry and somebody who doesn't get hasty. That is called sabr. And Allah says, I love those who have sabr, or those who are sabr. But my view in the sabr is only a character for you if it is always the case for you. Because sometimes people do have patience for a while, for a time. Because they are waiting for an opportunity, they are waiting for something. Once they get it, their sabr is over. So that's not called sabr. No, that's not called sabr. Quran makes a difference between noun and verb. Noun and verb. When he calls you by a noun, a name, that means it is permanent. You will never change. When he uses the word, the verb, that means that maybe sometimes, so maybe not sometimes. When Quran says somebody lied, and somebody is a liar, is very different. Somebody lied, that means that maybe sometimes he says the truth as well. When once Allah calls you a liar, you will never change. You're going to be a liar forever. Because it's a noun. And nouns are permanent. So we call character something that is permanently a feature of your personality, never changes. That is called character. It's called holo. It increases, doesn't decrease anymore. It doesn't increase. You can increase in sabo, increase in taqwa, and so forth, but there's no decrease. And that is borne by the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, alaykum bis sidq. Musa have had the hadith. فَإِنَّ الصِّدْقَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْبِرِّ وَإِنَّ الْبِرَّ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ وَلَا يَزَالُ الرَّجُلُ يَصْدُقُ وَيَتَحَرَّ الصِّدْقَ حَتَّى يُكْتَبَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ صِدِّقًا. He says that, I advise you to be truthful. Sidq. Because truthfulness leads you to piety. Piety leads you to paradise, the Jannah. A person says the truth. Yasduq. Wa yataharra sidq. And makes it a point to be truthful. That means he makes an effort to be truthful. It requires working on it. To acquire the character. He's truthful, he continues to make an effort to strive for truthfulness until when? Until is written with Allah, so and so is truthful. Siddiq. Once God is written, is never erased. I mean by a name, when it's written. حَتَّى يُكْتَبَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. What is عِنْدَ اللَّهِ? Doesn't change. Until such a person is written with Allah. The book does it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعِنْدَهُ أُمُّ الْكِتَابِ. The mother of the book is with him. Once it's written there, it's permanent. It will never change. So that becomes his character now. He can even if you want himself to change, he can't change it. It's written on you. كَتَبَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْإِيمَانِ وَأَيَّدَهُمْ بِرُوحٍ مِّنْهُ. Allah has written Iman on their hearts. It's written with the pen of Qudra that will never change. Once it's written, كَتَبَ. When it's written, it becomes your character. And لا تبدل كلمات الله. Allah's word will not change. لا تبدل لكلمات الله. ذلك الدين القيم. When it's written, it's never going to change. Until then, there's fluctuation. Sometimes you are truthful, sometimes you are not truthful. Sometimes you are patient, sometimes you lose your patience. When you see that, that means it's not written. So you are judge of yourself. So you keep your own account and see how you're doing. Today I got angry twice. That means that I'm not a sabir yet. I was patient. I was... But I'm not a patient one. So you can check it yourself. You can check yourself. But is that of sihi basira? Allah says, human being knows himself. He doesn't need me to confirm it for you. Just check yourself. If you get angry many times in a day, yeah, your name is not in the list of the sabirin. If you become a sabir, meaning it's your name in with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah loves you. And the reason why Allah's love is not binding for you before your name is written, because Allah does not like things that change. is not part of his qualities. No. Al-Qidam wal-Baqa, as in the basics of Tawheed. Qadimun Baqin. Allah is pre-eternal and everlasting. Things that change have nothing to do with God. Things that are permanent, yes, those are aligned with Him. Baqa and Qidam. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرْ إِلَىٰ صُوَرِكُمْ وَأَلْوَانِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ وَأَعْمَالِكُمْ. That Allah does not look at your form, your shape, and your colors, because these are things that are flux, they change. So Allah does not look at it. Whatever changes, doesn't look at it. Whatever is still and daim, وَلَهُ مَا سَكَنَ فِي اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ وَلَهُ. To Him belongs everything that is still by day and night. Stillness. So hence, once you have this characteristic, then Allah's love becomes binding. His love becomes binding for you. When His love is binding for you, His rahmah, His mercy also becomes binding. It's written for you. His mercy is written for you, which means that He will never punish you. Never. It's written, it's written. Said, Kataba ala nafsihi al-rahma. Kataba. Kataba fi qulubihim al-iman. Kataba ala nafsihi al-rahma. He's written iman in the hearts of the believers and has written mercy upon himself. So they go hand in hand. But who are those believers? The believers who have a character. Who have taken one of Allah's own characteristics. The Khalluq. And they said that for love to happen between two entities, there must be similarity between them. That's the basis of love. You must have things in common. So that's the basis of love and unity. And also the basis of hatred and disunity is having nothing in common. So once you take on Allah's characteristic, then Allah loves you because you have His characteristic. So Allah's Halim, you become a Halim. Allah's Sabur, you become Sabir. That's called Takhalluq. To take on the characters of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, that إنما بعثت لأتمم مكارم الأخلاق. He said, Allah sent me, my mission. Because every prophet has, they all have a general area, Tawheed, Salah, Zakah. This is, every prophet comes with this. Yet each of them has an area of concentration. Each of them has an area of concentration. Sayyidina Ibrahim was Tawheed, Shirk was his main concentration. Sayyidina Musa, Sharia, the law. Sayyidina Isa, charity and grace, the gospel. And Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, also came, he announced his particular area of concentration. Because this one, everybody does that. Salah and Zakah,
He says general.
Yet every messenger has an area to focus on. He said, my focus is on akhlaq. That's my area of concentration. إِنَّمَا بُعِسْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. God sent me to perfect noble characteristics. That's why I came. That's what is new about me, or different about me. Because Sarah has already come since Adam. Zakah was there since Adam. To be kind to your parents was there since Adam. So all this worship is there already. But character, that's my specialty. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in this case, came to teach us how to be loved by God. Because God will love you only because of your character and nothing else. God will love you only because of your character, not because of your worship. An ounce of good deed with character outweighs a mountain of worship without character. Yes, an ounce of good deed with character, with noble character, outweighs a mountain of good deed without character. And most likely, your good deeds, if you have no character, you may end up losing them. Because bad character does cause your good deeds. If you go to Surah Al-Hujurat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns the Sahabas about misconduct. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ إِلَيْهِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Or you who believe, don't go ahead of Allah and His Messenger. Because that is as a bad character. To go ahead of God and His Messenger. To put yourself before them. Supposed to follow them. The one that you're supposed to follow, now you are guiding them. You're walking ahead of them. Allah says, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ, beware of God. If you do that. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَرْفَوْا أَصْوَاتَكُمْ فَوْقَ صَوْتِ النَّبِيِّ. Or you who believe, don't raise your voice over the voice of the Messenger of Allah. So he's teaching the Sahabas how to have adab, good conduct, and character. Don't raise your voice above the voice of the Messenger of Allah. وَلَا تَجْهَرُوا لَهُ بِالْقَوْلِ كَجَهْرِ بَعْدِكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ. And don't speak to him the one way you speak to one another. And what was the consequences of that? Allah said, أَنْتَ حَبَتَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. If you do that, your deeds will become null and void. You don't even know. You think that a mountain of good deeds, when you go, you find nothing. Why? Because of your bad character. Because of your misconduct. Lack of adab. So you build and you demolish. He said to him that, you think that I am not entitled to the mercy of God. The son said, yes, you're entitled to Allah's mercy. He said, but that Allah says in the Quran, so Iblis is quoting Quran, which he knows very well naturally. Allah says, وَرَحْمَتِي وَسْعَتِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. My mercy encompasses everything. And I'm something. So when he says that, rahmati, and of course it's true, ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء. And Iblis is something for sure. وأنا شيء. So the same said, yes, you're right about that. But you have to complete the verse. Don't stop there. He said, the verse continues, says that, فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا الَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِآيَاتِنَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. I will write it. Allah says, my mercy encompasses everything. Yet, I will only write it. I will only write it. What does that mean? Writing it means what? Making it permanent. Only for those who have taqwa, who revere Allah. For those who give purifying dues, zakah. And for those who believe in my signs, I will write it for them. So Allah's mercy encompasses all of us. Those who believe in Him, those who don't believe in Him. Those who insult Him, those who revere Him. All of us, His mercy encompasses all of us. You can see that. There are people out there who insult Allah day and night. And they're having their rizq. They're well-to-do, prosperous. Yes. That's not the point. The point whether it's going to be written for you or not. For those who don't have taqwa and iman and tazkiyah, then it's going to be a waste. That mercy will come to an end. But for those who believe it is written for them, فَسَأَتُوهَا, I will write it. I'll make it binding for those who believe. I'll make it binding for those who have noble characters. Is it going to be written for you? Katara. Katara. So once it's written, it is a binding contract on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He will never punish you. No, He will not even reckon you. No reckoning. Once it's written, no reckoning for you. It's for those for who are so. If you have one of the seven characteristics, we're going to come to them before we conclude. Any of them, you'll go to Jannah without reckoning. Don't we want to have that privilege? Go to Jannah and there's no balance, don't see nothing, no balance, no books, nothing. You go straight to your final abode. Yes. Allah says, بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Those who are sabirun, by name, not by action, not by chance. Those who are sabirun permanently and written as a patient one, I'll give them their reward without reckoning, without calculation. Bighayri hisab. The same thing for tawakkul. In the hadith that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's in Bukhari as well, a Muslim, hadith of Ukasha, the Sahabi, well-known Sahabi, that when the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting with his companions, and he said to them, 70,000 from my ummah, my nation, will enter paradise without reckoning. 70,000. And then he described their characteristics. He said, الَّذِينَ لَا يَكْتَوُونَ وَلَا يَسْتَرِقُونَ وَلَا يَتَطَيَّرُونَ وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. 70,000 of my ummah will enter paradise without reckoning. They are the people who do not, it says that atatayu, we're going to work by, atatayu means that they are not superstitious. Before Islam in Arabia, when somebody is traveling, when they leave their home, and a bird flies on their left side of the road, then it's a bad sign. They cancel their trip and they go home. When the bird flies on their right side, then it's a good thing. They're going to tayamun wa tasha'un. So they're going to at-tatayyur. So those who don't do that, one, they don't go by horoscope signs. Today is, you know, this star is here, this star is here, so I can go. So tatayu, if you have tatayu, you cannot be among them. Wala yatatayu. Because that negates tawakkul. That's the characteristic. Tawakkul. To put your trust in God and go ahead with your plan. Don't look back. Don't look right or left. So la yatatayyaru. Wala yatta'un. And those who do not. Iktiwa is also is a type of healing by fire. They didn't use fire as a measure of healing.
Cauterization,
exactly. That's the word. Wala yaktawun. It's a Sahabi called Imran ibn Hussein. You must have known him. He got sick, and people told him that not the only way to get better is to cauterize. He refused. They prevailed with him finally. When he did it, before he did it, he used to, when he used to see it, he had the salam alaikum of the angels. The salam alaikum to him. When he did it, the salam alaikum stopped. And he cried. He said, you take away my, you know. Alhamdulillah, he came back after him. After he did cauterization. So, la yaktawu. Third one, ruqya. There's a ruqya mashru'a or ghayr mashru'a. There's ruqya which is allowed. To do ruqya on yourself is allowed. Meaning that it does not take away from the level of your tawakkul, but to ask ruqya to be done unto you, yes. Brings down the level of tawakkul. Is not forbidden, but it does not allow you to have that high tawakkul. So you do it for yourself, that's fine. That does not in any way compromise your talk. To ask for it to be done on you does compromise your talk. So wala yastariqun wa ala rabbihim yatawakkal. So tawakkul will take you to Jannah without reckoning. So when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that, this Sahabi, Ukasha, he got up. He said, O Messenger of Allah, ask Allah to make me one of them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, you are one of them. You are one of them. Then after he sat down, somebody else got up. Mother Sahabi. He said, O Messenger of Allah, ask me to make me one of them. He said, it's too late. Sabakaka biha Ukasha. He said, Ukasha took it away already. Why he said, it's too late? Probably he did not, because it's a timing also. Maybe he waited too long to ask. His dua also has time, the moment, to hit the moment. Don't wait. It's part of tawakkul as well. When you have tawakkul, you don't hesitate. Allah said, فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. When you make up your mind, move ahead. Don't look back. So that is tawakkul. That's one of the characteristics that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, and He will write rahmah for you and will send you to Jannah without reckoning. Because reckoning does entail some time of punishment. If Allah reckons you, it's a kind of punishment. When there's no punishment, there's rahmah only, then you go without ghayr hisab. That's why he said, "Man nuqsha al-hisab 'udhiba." As Umm Salma, if Allah audits you thoroughly, that means that He wants to punish you. Otherwise, He'll just say, "Go." You go. Go to your place. So these characteristics that Allah loves, and Allah will write rahmah for you in some, there are seven major characteristics. Seven major characters, which are all mentioned in the Quran and also in the Sunnah. Now I'm going to try with not those who have attended my classes, so you don't raise your hand. So I want to deal with only with those who are for the first time hearing about the subject. So we're gonna go. I just want to gauge you how much your Quran is, how much is smooth, and how much you read your Quran. Because if you do, I will know. If you read every day Quran, I will know by the question I'm going to ask you. So let's see who reads Quran thoroughly, or how Quran thoroughly. So then I said there are seven characteristics mentioned in the Quran that God loves, and loves those who have them, and have His mercy written for them. Bighayri hisab. Seven of them. And each of them in the Quran has the word love attached to them. God says, God loves. So this is where He says, God loves in the Quran. Whenever you see that, it means that one of those characteristics. And do not go on the phone either. I've seen that happening many times. And they Google the word love in the Quran. That is not good. It's not good. If you do that, you will not learn. You need to learn by memory. So we have one hand raised. Yes? Patient? Yes. That's one of them. Inna Allaha yuhibbu as-sabirin. In Surah 2, Ali Imran, Baqara 2. MashaAllah, this is impressive. Assalamu alaikum, brother. Allah loves those who keep their duty. Do you know the word for that? No, one single word. Okay, I'll come back to you then. It's just correct, but you want the Arabic word for it. Yes, sister? To worship Him, yes. But what's the word for that? Do you have any word for that, sister? One single word? Okay, we'll come back to that. Yes, sister. What is muttaqin? People who have taqwa, yes. That's one of the seven. Wallahu yuhibbul muttaqin. Taqwa means reverence, to revere God. To revere Him. So that's two. Yes, brother?
Steadfast.
Somebody mentioned that already. Sabr. Thank you very much. That's the same thing as sabr. Steadfastness. Now?
Hubu shakirin?
Yes, but there's nothing like that in the Quran. There's no Allahu yuhibbu shakirin. Even though it's true, of course, because sabr leads you to shukr. But there's textual in the Quran, there's no wallahu yuhibbu shakirin. So I just want those ones, those 7 ones, to come back for that.
All
right. Yes, brother. Inna Allah yuhibbu al-mutatahhirin. Those who purify themselves inwardly and outwardly, in heart and body and soul. So tahara is the third one. Any hands, sister? Yes? Tawabin, yes, yes, barakallah. Huh? Inna Allah yuhibbu at-tawabin. Those who not only make tawbah once in a while, those who make tawbah all the time, characteristically, tawabin. So that's 4 of them. We have 3 more to go. So one from the main side, yes, brother?
One who keeps his promises.
Huh?
One who keeps his promises.
Yes, except that that's part of tahara. That's part of the word tahara. We'll come to that when we break them down into their components, inshallah. Sister?
As-salamu alaykum
wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allah loves the truthful.
Those are truthful? Okay. What is the word for that in the Quran? But there's nothing like that in the Quran. Wallahi yuhibbu as-sadiqin is not there. Even though it's true, of course. But sidq is a component of a character and not a whole character. So that's why. We'll come to that, inshallah. Yes? Mutawakkilin. Barakallah. We already discussed tawakkul. God loves those who put their trust in Him. Yuhibbul mutawakkilin. So we have 2 more to go. Nobody's on the phone, huh? Yes? Barakallah. Thank you, brother. Wallahu yuhibbu al-muhsinin ihsan. Those who act in excellence all the time. Huh? It doesn't fluctuate. They do a good job today and tomorrow. Huh? They are mediocre. No. Yes? Safan. But that is part of sabr. So, yeah. Inshallah, we'll come to that. Yes, sister? Yeah, somebody mentioned that. Well, thank you. Yes, sister? It's true. How do you call that in the Quran? Very good. That's the last one, actually. Huh? She said the meaning in English correctly, equity. Muqsitin. Wallahu yuhibbu al-muqsitin. Allah loves those who are upright, equitable. So these are the 7 loves in the Quran. The 7 categories of people that God loves. And try to be at least in one of the groups. Because I don't think you can manage to do all of them in one life. But try to be at least one. To be known, something that everybody can know you for. No, so-and-so is very patient, so you are known for that. Or so-and-so is very trusting in God. So these are the 7. But now each of these 7, as I said, has 2 components. If you have to break it down into 2. So that comes down to 14 components. 14. 7 words and 14 components. Yes. I will go to board for that. is composed of two sides. When they come together, it becomes a full character. And I just mentioned the one, the man who came late after the caravan, and I said that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said you have two characteristics. What are they? Do you remember that? Anybody remembers? Al-Hilmu wal-Anat. So we will start with that. That's Sabu. Al-Sabu has two components. Al-Hilmu wal-Anat. So Hilm is forbearance, magnanimity, clemency. And Anat is what? Not being hasty. So as we call that, it's an old English word called to be positive, to pose. Positiveness. And magnanimity. True. Somebody can give me one of the seven characteristics, one of them?
Taqwa.
And then we'll put taqwa. So taqwa, God reverence, and also has two components. Because unless you know the components, it's hard for you to take on this character. Yeah? But once you break it down, now you know what sabr means. Sabr means to be halim, and to muta'anni. Someone doesn't get hasty and then get angry. So that's sabr. So taqwa also has two components. When we hear somebody is a muttaqi, he has to have those two in balance. Any idea? Yes, brother? No? Hope and fear. That's one of the same, but not this one, not taqwa. We'll see. One of them has those two. Yes?
Consciousness.
Yes. Which type? Because I want it to be concrete and not just abstract ideas. Because then you cannot implement it. Huh? No? Well, that's kind of the background of all of this. You have to have faith to have any of this, naturally. In Quran, so they are both in the Quran also. I'll give you in Surah 2 Al-Baqarah, God says, "Illa an yafoon, aw yafoo alladhi biyadihi uqdatu nikah, wa an ta'foo aqrab." للتقوى وأن تعفو أقرب للتقوى. That you pardon is closer to taqwa. So closer. It's not all of it, but it's part of it. So that's one. That's one. What is that? Al-afu. Al-afu. Afu means what? No. Forgiveness and pardoning doesn't mean the same thing. I mean, English is your language, not mine. What is it? Doesn't mean the same thing. Until the age of 13, I don't know ABC. I was in the village, completely sheltered from the outer world. So only at the age of 13, I saw the English letters when I moved to the town. So of course, I'm not a native speaker. Yeah, so afu is pardon. To pardon and to forgive doesn't mean the same thing. What's the difference between them? Pardoning and forgiving. Yes?
So part of it is like it didn't happen. Like it's erased completely. Mm-hmm. But to forgive is just like it's still there, the residue is still there of what they did, but it's still, the memory is there, but the pardoning is like it's erased.
Any other suggestion on top of that? Yes?
You have the ability to punish, but you choose not to.
That's fine then.
Yes.
I'm going to forgive him, man.
Let it go.
Yeah. So, when you say pardon has to do with something that is your right. If you owe me a right, and I forego my right on you, so I said I pardon you, then you don't have to give me the right that you owe me. So forgiving has to do when you do something wrong. So that's forgiving has to do with doing wrong and then forgiving the wrong. But pardoning is letting go of the whole or part of your right to somebody. So there is a difference between them. Al-afu wal-ghufran in the Quran. So afu is pardon. And I think if you can stretch your linguistic ability a bit, if you can find the opposite of, something that balances that, not opposite. What would that be? Pardoning and what?
Sacrifice.
No, those are still on the same side. Something that counterbalances.
Justice.
Yes. Justice. This has to go hand in hand. Qala al-adl. So he said, "Wa anta afu aqrab lit-taqwa," in Surah Al-Baqarah. When we go al-Ma'idah, Allah says, "I'dilu huwa aqrab lit-taqwa." Be just. And that's closer to taqwa. So afu brings you halfway, adl brings you halfway, you have all of taqwa. If you are able to balance them. But that to the point that it will take a long time, so I'll have to keep you here all this morning. But anyway, why do you have to be balanced? Because if we just pardon without justice, justice is Allah's name, Al-Adil, Allah's name, the just. So we are actually abrogating something that's Allah's characteristic. And that also is not good. So you pardon some, you take some. You take part of your right, you let go of part of your right. So Afu and Adil, they meet together. Let go of some and take some. Between letting go and taking. So have a balance. That's called taqwa. Al-adil wal-afu. And they are both Allah's name. Al-afu, al-adil, the 99 names. You can see that all this goes back to Allah's names, but we haven't got to that yet. So all the 99 names, you can break down and subsume them under one of these, under these seven characteristics. So we go to number three. Anybody give us one of the seven characteristics?
Ihsan.
No?
Muhsinin.
It's not easy to figure it out. Ah, mashallah. Yes, brother?
The hadith, they said, what is it, Ihsan, to worship Allah as if he sees you, or you see him?
Mm-hmm. So, what does that boil down to? That's very good. That's a good start for us, brother. Yes? Yeah, but when to break it down, when you say somebody has an excellent character, what? Because it's all about balance, as you can see. If not, put fear after he sees you. Because if somebody sees you, you don't see them, you have fear of them. Yes?
Yaqeen?
Now?
Yaqeen?
Yes. So, that boils down to khawf and tama. In Surah Al-A'raf, he says, "Udu'u rabbakum tadarru'an wa khufiyatan innahu la yuhibbu al-mu'tarin wa la tufsidu fil ardi ba'da islahiha wadu'uhu khawfan wa tama'an inna رحمت الله قريب من المحسنين أعراف So khawf and tamah will lead you to excellence in worship. If you worship only out of hope, then you will tend to relax. If you worship only out of fear, you may tend to despair. If you can balance them, then you are excellent in your worship. Then, yes, I said, if you worship him only out of hope, you may become over-optimistic or wishful thinking. If you worship him only out of fear, you may despair as well. And usually Shaitan works on these two. One time he'll come to you and only whispers in your mind only the hope aspects of God. No, don't have problem. Do this. No. God is very forgiving. If you disobey him just a little bit, he will not mind. So that's his pushing you. But he only tells you at this point that God is forgiving. God is, he doesn't tell you any side of God's justice. He's encouraging you to transgress. Once you transgress, then justice will come. He'll tell you now, you are hopeless. You've done this awesome sin, there's no pardoning for you. So he brings God's justice to you at this point, to despair you from coming back to God. So if you do make a mistake, come back. So four, somebody give us the name? No? Tahara. Barakallah. Tahara means what? Purity or candle. Candle, that's what I translate usually. But I mean, very candid. So, tahar. Purity of soul and body, and mind, and heart. Tahara, بكل معنى الكلمة. Inshallah, we're going to come to, each of these has an opposite too in the Quran. Do you think you have the patience to stay with opposites as well tonight? Yeah. Or now your patience comes on. I won't keep you longer than you can bear. But they have opposites, as you know. If you know something, make sure you find the opposite. Because knowing something and not knowing the opposite does not immune you from falling in the opposite. So always know what negates something that is good. And the Sahabi of Hudayfa says, people used to ask the Messenger of Allah والسلام, what is good for me to do? He said, I used to ask him what is bad to do for fear of falling in it. So it's good to know khayr, to cultivate it. Good to know shar, to keep away from it. Then your khair becomes pure for you. So tahara. Inna Allah yuhibbu al-tawwabin wa yuhibbu al-mutatahhirin. Fihi rijal yuhibbuna an yatatahharu. Wallahu yuhibbu al-mutatahhirin. So tahara has the opposite will help you figure it out. The opposite of tahara is khiyana. Khiyana. Khiyana means what? Treachery, deception, cheating. That's the opposite of this. Whatever it is, very hard to figure out the components. So, what will be the component of tahara? Okay. I'll come back. Yes. Silk. Yes. What does silk mean? Okay. Yes, brother. So the word ikhlas And Tahara means the same thing. So you say, Mukhlisin and Mutahira mean the same thing. So, but the component of Ikhlas now, that's what you want. Ikhlas against Khiyana, treachery. Sincerity. How do you call that in Arabic?
Haq.
Haq is truth.
I didn't speak
Arabic. I'm sorry. My accent, I thought you were Egyptian. I'm sorry. I'll put down this one for you.
What's that?
Wafa. Wafa means what?
Loyalty.
Loyalty being fulfilling your commitment. To fulfill your commitment. To fulfill your promise. It's called Wafa. And the Quran talks about Wafa. Those who fulfill their promise, those who fulfill their vows. When you promise, you fulfill. As the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ayatul Munafiq Thalatha, the signs of a Munafiq, that's the Khayyam. The signs of a Munafiq is three things. Idha haddatha, kadhab. If he speaks, he lies. Wa idha wa'ada, akhlafa. If he promises, he fails. Wa idha utumina khan, when he entrusts him, he cheats. So that's the opposite of tahar. Nifaq. So God loves those who their heart is pure from nifaq. There's no hypocrisy in their hearts. When they promise, they fulfill their promise. When they speak, they are truthful. And when they are entrusted, they keep the trust. They don't cheat. Wallahu la yuhibbu al-kha'ineen. So we come to la yuhib. We have covered all the yuhib. Now we come to la yuhib. Why don't we finish this? So wafa and what?
Shukr.
And birr. Al wafa wal birr. Birr, piety. Piety. Wa ta'awanu ala al birr wa taqwa. 5. Somebody give us one of the words, one of the characteristics. Now, tawakkul, tawakkul, reliance on God, or putting your trust in God. Now, anybody has any idea about the component of tawakkul? Now? Yes. But which aspect of belief? Because belief has different levels. No, yaqeen, no. Yaqeen is sort of also is kind of a background. Yaqeen and iman are the background of all this. Somebody was saying something here? Trust. Yeah, that's the word trust itself. But how do we break it down? To have tawakkul. When somebody put his trust in God, what are his characteristics?
Yes.
No? So we call that what? I think this word? How do you call somebody who's when he makes his mind, he moves forward. How do you just
determine?
Resolve. Hold that. Azm. Allah says, "What is the azm?" That is in the ayah. So azm, resolve.
Not stubborn.
Not stubborn. is fruitless. Once, that you do not waver and hesitate. That's not a character of a believer.
believer, when once you put your trust in God, then you move forward and you don't look back. So that's Azm. And the other one is Sidq, which the sister gave us earlier. Sidq. فَإِذَا عَزَمَ الْأَمْرُ فَلَوْ صَدَقُوا اللَّهَ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ. Sidq now is sincere. Sidq. Sincere. Six. Tawabin. Okay. When we say make tawbah to Allah, what are the steps? There are two steps. What are they?
Acknowledgement.
Yes. Intention. Intention is kind of universal. They all need intention. Yes. This one too, I just need precise terms. There's an explanation. No? Humility? Yes. That's a very important aspect. How do we translate that? It's not precise. Now, sister? Regret, yeah, that's an aspect of the two components, but there are two specific components that are in the Quran. That's what I want. One is called humbleness, yeah. It's called Taslim. Al-Taslim. And the second one is called Al-Inaba. Al-Inaba. Inaba means what? Inaba means what? Anaba. You need. Munin. The turn back. I mean, each time something goes wrong, before you try to fix it on your own, turn back. Bring it back to God. Bring all your matters back to God. That's called inab. Whenever something happens, bring the matter back to God. That's called inab. And give it to God. Once you give the matter back to God, and then God makes a decision for you, what do you do? You submit. That's called taslim. So inaba, come back. Taslim, accept God's judgment. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Some people didn't come, but when it's not in their favor, Allah says that. When, that's context about those who, when they are called to come for settling a matter with the Messenger of Allah, when they know it's in their favor, they'll come. The judgment is going to go in their favor. When they know that it's going to be against, they don't come. So that doesn't work. Huh? You come back to Allah when it's for you or against you. So that's inaba, turning back to God, and then taslim. And both of them are in one surah two, Az-Zumar, وَأَنِيبُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُمْ. In Zumar, and also in An-Nisa. An-Nisa as well. And then inshallah we look for a final. Muqsitin. Qist. Qist. That one will not be easy to find. Yeah. I hope that inshallah everybody can memorize this, because you need to know this by heart. If you know this by heart, you know, you already got the key to enter Quran. So this is the basic of Quran. Quran is based on these seven characteristics and their components. So 14 components, and there are seven opposite, and there are 14 components as well.
So that comes down to 28 components. The number of the alphabet, letters of the alphabet, 28 letters. So these are the letters of the Quran, 28 letters of the Quran. If you know them by heart, Quran, inshallah, will become easy for you to understand. Naam, sister. How are you, sister? So that's kind of that's within these two, but they're going to, because each time you go back to God is going to correct you, God is going to improve you each time you go back. It doesn't matter how many times you go back, each time you go back you get better. Remember that the hadith of Isra and Mi'raj that said that Musa was then the person go back to God. He goes back, becomes easier. From 50, he comes down to 5, because of Tawbah. So each time you go back, it gets easier. What Tawbah does for you. Something is, if you have a problem and something is hard for you, go back to God. It might become lighter. Because you bring the matter back to him and give it to him. He carries it for you. You don't carry the burden. But if you keep dealing with it and struggling with it, it's heavy for you, you'll be in agony constantly. So a test has two components. One is called Islah. This one you have to figure out. And one is called Tawfiq. Islah and Tawfiq. Nasir, وَمَا تَوْفِيقِ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ مَا تَوْفِيقِ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ إِنَّ أَرَدْتُ إِلَّا الْإِصْلَاحِ مَا تَوْفِيقِ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ أَرَدْتُ إِلَّا الْإِصْلَاحِ مَا تَوْفِيقِ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. Allah says, I only want to reconcile, to do something that is good. It's called Islah. And Tawfiq, concordance. Reconciliation and concordance, to reconcile. So these are the 14 characteristics of the 7 characters that God loves. And then, quickly, have you raised them and put them out? No?
You turn the board around.
All good, mashallah.
No, no, it's something here. I'm sorry. I can't even accept that.
No, it's okay. I can use this. Everybody has it, isn't it?
Yes, of course.
Because I'm going, before we close, I'm going to ask a question to everyone. Okay, now the opposites. So, the opposite of, we start with Tawbah. He said, somebody was told that about humility. I had that word quite a bit here. So the opposite of Tawbah, if Tawbah is humility, what's the opposite? Arrogance. So we're going to come, Fakhur is in another one. Arrogance. How do you call it in Arabic?
Kibr.
In the Quran he says what? Wallahu la yuhibbul mustakbiri. La yuhibbul. Istikbar. So that one? So that's istikbar. Two, tahar. Already mentioned earlier, hopefully somebody attended. Now tahara, purity, and the opposite is what? So, what is the opposite? Yes? Yeah. Khiyana. Kira means what? Deception, treachery. Three, taqwa, which means respecting your boundaries and don't try and don't transgress. So the opposite of taqwa is what? Transgression, exactly. Transgression, we call that what? Udwan. Allahu la yuhibbul mu'tadin. Allahu la yuhibbul mu'tadin. Udwan. Yes, on the opposite. On this one too. Udwan. So transgression. And Ihsan was the opposite. That's one of the opposite, but not for the Ihsan. You can keep that for later. Ihsan if you can remember all the in Quran, La yuhibbu, La yuhibbu. That's why. Yes?
Mufsidin
is one of them, but not for Ihsan. One of the most important terms in the Quran. Zulm. La yuhibbu al-zalimin. Yuhibbu al-zalimin. So zulm. And we come to sabr. There's no la yuhibbu al-khalid in the Quran, so we can use that. Only the la yuhibbu in the Quran. What does impatience? Yeah. If you are impatient, what happens? And when you are hasty, what happens?
Anger.
When you get angry, what happens? Yeah, when you get angry, what happens? What was the result of anger or haste? What happens? Because the consequence, yeah. What's the consequence of that? When somebody is angry or hasty and is doing something, what does he do? He breaks it? We call that what? The one that you gave me before.
Mufsidin.
Mufsidin. Lack of sabr leads to fasad. If Allah gets angry, this whole world goes to nothing. Let's go. He doesn't get angry because he's halim. So sabr leads to fasad. Or lack of sabr, sorry. Allahu la yuhibbu al-mufsidin. So we have two more to go. The answer you've been giving me. But there's only one word also, just one word. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ قَوْمُهُ لَا تَفْرَحْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ لَا. That's there, but one word. No? لَا يُحِبُّ الْفَرْحِينَ لا تفرح إن الله لا يحب الفرحين. So tawakkul, to put your trust in God. Al-farah is to exult and overjoy on something other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you're joyful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's good. To overjoy because of your possessions, that's against tawakkul. Because then you rely on your on your possession instead of relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's the, so that's called al-farah. Farah. Thambina al-kulla muhtalim faqur. So last one, qist, being equitable and being upright. Hopefully this one should not be hard. To be upright or to be equitable will lead to what? Opposite of that should be easy. What would that be? Kadhibin. There's no kadhibin in the Quran. La yuhibbul kadhibin. Even though that the meaning is true, the Quran didn't say that. When the word la yuhib. What do you like? There's one la yuhib left now that we need to find. Yes, brother? Zalimin? Oh, Mutalin and Zalimin, we already have them. Well, one is here. Zulm is here.
Kafirin.
Kafirin. Yes? Who said that? Musrifin. Yeah, Israf. Wa'atu haqqahu yawma hasadihi wa la tusrifu. Inna Allah la yuhibbu al-musrifin. So, israf. So these are the seven characteristics that God loves and the seven that God doesn't love. Allah. Is it hizbun qalilun wa fahmun kathirun? So short lesson and loss of understanding. So I won't make it too long, but this is quite a lot already. So it'll take you a long time to process it and but retain it, memorize them. Don't depend on the phone.
What about their characteristics?
No?
Their components.
Are we okay with giving the components? I don't want to Okay, let's look at the components. Arrogance. We start with arrogance. Can anybody think about the components of arrogance? If somebody says somebody is arrogant, what does it mean? Yes, that's one of them. Barakallah, sister. We call that? You got it. وَطَوْلْ حَقِّ وَغَمْتِ النَّاسِ. Thank you. Two, defy the truth. When they say accept the truth, it's fight against the truth. If I receive the truth. And then to look down on people, called وَغَمْتِ النَّاسِ. That's what constitutes kibur. وَلِيَازُ بِاللَّهِ. If you have مِسْخَالَ دَرَّ of kibur, you can enter Jannah. مِسْخَالَ دَرَّ. Atom size of arrogance, you cannot enter paradise. If you look down on people, you can't enter paradise. If you defy the truth, you can't enter paradise. So, batarul haq, ghamt al-nas. So, batar, ghamt, just to shorten it. Khiyana. Treachery, deception. What are the components? Kadhib. And what?
Nifaq.
Nifaq. I'll accept those, but I have standard. But those are exceptions. Kadhib. Okay. Meaning lying. And nifah, hypocrisy. But usually we use the word ikhlaf. Ikhlaf. Ikhlaf means what? You fail your promise. So you have to match it with other components. We have the wafa and birr. So the opposite of wafa is ikhlaf, to fail your promise. And the opposite of birr is what? Ifhim. And ifhim. So. So ifhim, impiety, ikhlaf, failing the promise. So those are the two components of deception or treachery. If you come to Udwan, transgression, which is the opposite of what?
Taqwa.
Good. It's not the opposite. So the components of Udwan is what? Taqwa, we said it was afu and adil. To pardon and to be just. Is its own word. No?
Injustice.
Injustice. And what? Yes?
Fujur.
Fujur and what? It's very good. That's one of them. Fujur. So fujur is the opposite of afu. Afu was what? Pardoning. So not to unpardonable, not somebody who doesn't pardon, who takes all his right. And because the danger is that if you take all your right, you end up also transgressing. That's what happens. If you take all your right. You know the story of the Merchant of Venice. I'm sure you are familiar with Shakespeare. I think even the story. The pound of flesh. So the problem is that if you want to cut your pound of flesh, if you can't live, well, it might get a little bit more, a little bit less. So that's the problem with afu. So khud al-afwa, that's why we said, just let go of some of your life, in case you don't be the one who take more than your rights. So that's what fujur is. And the other one is, that jaw. Is to be unfair. Simply. As was the father. And we go to the fourth one, which is sabr. We have Hilm and Anat, so it's going to be easy for you to find the opposite. Magnanimity and being positive. So now the opposite is what? To rush. To rush is what? Exactly. To rush against Ajala. So we have, that's Ajala, meaning to be hasty. And the other one is what? Anger. Rather. So hastiness and anger. Hastiness and anger. And then we come to Vul, which is against Ihsan. And the opposite of what? Sabr. The opposite of sabr was fasad. Yes. Corruption.
True.
Yeah. To break everything. And its components are hastiness and anger.
So dhulm, which is the opposite of ihsan. What are the components? We have here, they are khawf and tamah. Greed. We said that hope without fear leads you to what? Wishful thinking. Over optimism. And fear without hope leads you what?
Despair.
So you can get, you can drive the component from that. So here, amal is the word, but when the amal is kind of vain, how do we call it? We call it al-amani. Al-amani, kind of wishful thinking. Tilka amaniyukum. Amani. Amani and ghurur. Ghurur means delusion. And then we come to So farah, barakallah. That's farah, which is against tawakkul. Farah against tawakkul. Which is the easiest, probably. You have been, brother has been harping on that for all the time, so we get it now. What are they? Muqtalin, fakhul. So that's. So Muqtalin is called to be conceited. Conceit. Fakhulin is what? Boastful. The boastful and conceited. So those are the, when somebody is overjoyed about their possession or their acquisition or their achievement, they become boastful and conceited. Yes, brother?
There is
no, they mean the same thing. In the Quran, yeah. The same thing. MashaAllah, Allah helped us to get to Fakhur. So Muqtalin, Fakhur. Muqtal, Fakhur. Like those who don't read Arabic. Muqtal, Fakhur. Ikhtiyal is the root of the word, and Fakhur. So we have the seventh one, which is Israf, isn't it?
Israf.
And we had for qist, islah and tawfiq, isn't it? Okay.
Could it be khuldan or fasad?
Because fasad already we have is against sabr, so we don't want to use that again. So we need to look for other times. So we said concordance, which translates into discordance. Tawfiq is concordance and discordance. What would that be? So Islah is to reconcile. Sulh. So the opposite of that would be what?
Separate.
Exactly. So you call that?
Shadow.
Tafriq. Very good. And the other one will be what? This quadrant will be what?
Nizar.
It's nizah, but I want to word that Quran is precisely. That's good. Barakallah. No, it's outside of that. It's correct. It's one of the word, that's all. Good. اختلاف هذا يكون ذا الذين تفرقوا واختلفوا تفرقوا واختلف اختلاف discordance disunity اختلاف so now we have 28 components
Didn't we use ikhlaf as the opposite of khiyana? I mean, as one of the components of khiyana?
We did.
So what's the difference between khilaf and ikhlaf?
They are different. Ikhlaf is to fail a promise. Ikhtilaf is to have a difference of opinion. Israf itself means, oh yes, we didn't translate it, huh? That's true. It's translated as extravagance. Extravagance. Yeah, Israf. Extravagance.